Welcome everybody to the 2023 CGC Summer School Finale Concert. We've been gathered here with people, musicians from all over the world. I'll tell you a bit more about them. We've come together for a week of learning and making music for instruction, for inspiration, for courageous performances, and tonight you're going to see some of them. So we're going to have five ensembles play for you, and then you're going to see quite a sight to behold where there'll be 70 guitarists up on stage playing in guitar orchestra. I'd like to introduce the first ensemble that is led by Dr. Janet Agostino and also Nicoletta Todesco. Janet will be conducting Processional by Richard Charlton, which is arranged by Richard Charlton, and Nicoletta will be conducting Kimono by Annette Crowspring. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
So once again, that was Processional, arranged by Richard Charlton, medieval themes arranged by Richard Charlton. And then the second piece, conducted by Nicoletta Tedesco, was Kimono by Annette Prusbrink. So I mentioned that there is quite an international representation here, and we are in Massachusetts, in the northeast of the United States. We have participants here from Brussels, from Mexico, from Great Britain, from Sweden, from New Zealand, from Australia. So it really is an international gathering. Really, we're brought together because we're part of the community at Classical Guitar Corner, but more so because we share an appreciation and a passion for the classical guitar. And what we do in these weeks is largely inspired by the Sydney Summer School, which has been run for several decades, and of which Richard Charlton, Raphael Agostino, Janet Agostino, and Chris Keane have been founders of. We actually give the music to the participants, to the musicians, at the beginning of the week. There's only 5 days, and they get the music on day one. They've never seen this music before, and I'm sure you'll agree with me that it's quite an amazing feat to get a performance ready within those 5 days. A lot of people get very daunted by the fact that we have to get this music, ensemble music, there's solo performances, there's an orchestra performance, all done within 5 days. But we focus in on the skill of making music as a group, and also, you know, as solo classical guitarists, I know a lot of people watching are classical guitarists, you focus on being correct and not making mistakes, but here we're trying to get something to come together in this short period of time, and that actually requires a different skill set of which we get to work on here. So it looks like this next group is ready. James Erickson is going to lead the next group. He's going to conduct Partial Eclipse, which is also an original composition by Richard Charlton. And then it's followed by O Shenandoah, arranged by Alan Hirsch.
Thank you.
Thank you to James and his group for performing Partial Eclipse by Richard Charlton and O Shenandoah, arranged by Alan Hirsch. The next group is going to be led by Joao Luis. And Joao is one of our guests that has joined us. He lives in New York, but he was born in Brazil. And he's one of the phenomenal duo partners from the Brazil duo, including many other ensemble projects. During this week, we have teachers that share their knowledge and inspiration, and Joao gave us a performance of Brazilian music that had an authenticity that I think we were all very inspired by, and he proceeded to give us a presentation about how to play Brazilian music, how to approach music perhaps from other cultures by immersing yourself, in this case, in the world of dance, listening to music, the choro music of Brazil, and it was a wonderful insight into music that we very much love as musicians. Now, I know there's a number of summer school alumni on the chat, so hello to Kerry and Scott, Mark Cohen, Drew Burgess, Yoko, thank you for tuning in, thank you for saying hello, we miss you, and hopefully we'll see you at another summer school. We haven't done this summer school for 3 years. We did 2017, 2018, 2019, we've had a big pause, and we're very grateful to be back together again to make music. So Joao Luis is going to conduct Bamboo Calypso by Thierry Tisserand. Mm-hmm. Congratulate all the performers again for the fact that they've just learned this music over a period of 5 days, and now we're putting it together in a final concert that you can enjoy all over the world. We've had some really wonderful concerts throughout the summer school. Each evening we have concerts, sometimes by the visiting artists and teachers, and sometimes by the participants, the musicians themselves. We've had a really diverse array this summer school. We've had João Luiz gave his performance with Brazilian music. Nicoleta Todesco, who conducted one of the first pieces and will conduct the orchestra, she performed some original works using her voice as well as playing. And Jeff Peterson brought us music from the slack key tradition of Hawaii, I pronounced it correctly. And he played some beautiful music from the ukulele. And he is going to conduct the next two pieces, the first of which he arranged, which is He Mele Lahui Hawaii. I hope I pronounced that
beautifully.
By Liliu Okalani. So this is Jeff's own arrangement. And following that will be Chiroc by Giorgio Signorile. And our very own Dave Belcher will be the soloist in that piece.
Thank you.
Thank you to Jeff and to his group, and also for the soloist, Dave Belcher, who seems to have broken the internet with the fact that he's shaved off his beard. A lot of you have known Dave throughout the years, through the screen anyway, with his majestic beard, and the consensus is you look very handsome without it. We've gone for a big hair chop here at CGC. We're getting rid of it. It's a big, all the trend. So thank you for all the lovely comments. There's about 200 people between Facebook and YouTube watching. Thank you very much for tuning in. It means the world to have an audience, to have your support. We really appreciate it. Throughout the week, we have a lot of lessons every day. So all our guest teachers are working with musicians here at the camp. And yesterday, in the evening and the day before during the day, we had an open mic, and it was really inspiring to see people take a courageous leap onto the stage, some never having performed in front of other people before, some not having done it for many, many years, like many of us, and it was really a beautiful and touching two sessions to watch everyone be up there, share their artistry, take the courageous step, and be resoundingly applauded by the rest of the community here at the Summer School. The next group is led by Raphael Agostino from Sydney, Australia. They're going to play three folk songs arranged by Jeremy Sparks: Wade in the Water, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, and St. James Infirmary. Following that, they're going to play Tango by Mark Horton.
Thank you.
So that concludes our ensemble performances, and thank you everyone watching for all your congratulations and your claps and your emojis. And there was one person who gave us a thumbs down, and that's okay. That's okay, we can live with that. But, you know, people often talk about the challenge of... I asked the chat what 70 times 6 is. Does anyone know what 70 times 6 is?
420.
Is it 420? Oh, I get the joke now. How to tune 420 strings, and how to get, you know, 70 guitarists on the stage playing in time together, playing in tune together, all eyes on a conductor. But no one talks about the difficulty of emceeing while you set up a guitar orchestra. This is a true challenge. So I would like to invite Jeff Peterson to come and talk about the first piece that is going to be performed. This is a waltz that Jeff will tell us about. So Jeff, thank you.
Thanks for coming out. Yeah, aloha everyone. So we're going to start out with this amazing guitar orchestra. It's so much fun to be here from Hawaii for my first time actually in this area in Boston. It's been absolutely beautiful. The students are an inspiration. I've learned so much from them, and just such an honor to be here. So we're going to start out by doing a beautiful arrangement that was done by Ian O'Sullivan. A wonderful song celebrating King Kamehameha the Great. It's called Kamehameha Waltz. It also celebrates, though, the composer, Charles E. King. He wrote this in 1917, and it was a tribute to his alma mater at Kamehameha School. And the school was set up by the Bernice Pauahi estate. She was part of the ali'i, or the royal family, during the monarchy in Hawaii. And she left her trust to ensure that Hawaiian children had the opportunity to have a full education. And this institution is still thriving to this day, and this song really is a great testament to the early days of Kamehameha schools. And Charles E. King was one of the first publishers of Hawaiian music, so he really brought a lot of attention to the music. Not only a great composer and arranger, but he published music by composers who their music wouldn't be heard otherwise. So there's a lot of reverence for him in Hawaii. And so this piece is really inspired by the monarchy style of the waltz. And Henry Berger was this amazing band leader and composer that was brought to Hawaii in around the 1870s. And he mentored the ali'i, a group called Nalani Eha, which was King Kalakaua, Liliuokalani, Princess Like Like, and Prince Leleohoku, among many others in that sort of monarchy time in Hawaii. And he was actually a protege of Strauss, of Johann Strauss, and so he loved the waltz rhythm. So you'll notice this is very much in the style of a German waltz. Imagine the palm trees swaying and some trade winds blowing through, beautiful beach, the surf coming in, and then you'll hear what Kamehameha Waltz is all about. And I brought my ukulele to celebrate. I'm just going to sit in and have a little conga feel session with everyone.
Thank you so much,
John. Thank you.
It was 418 strings. I was too off because of the ukulele. Sorry, I didn't count for it. Following the waltz that Jeff so kindly talked about, we're going to have two arrangements by our very own Dr. Janet Agostino. So it's worth mentioning, and I know her daughter is proudly watching from the UK right now. Janet actually achieved her PhD last year. Now we're very proud of her to be named Dr. Agostino. We're very privileged to have her leading the orchestra along with Nicoleta Todesco. And she has arranged Balletto by Respighi.
Balletto, detto il conto, au revoir.
Can you, Nikki, do you want to double up?
Oh no, Nikki should.
Come on, you got it.
Okay, together. Balletto,
detto il conte Orlando.
That's what I said.
Yeah.
That's what I said. From Ancient Airs and Dances by Respighi. And it's going to be followed by It Don't Mean a Thing If You Ain't Got That Swing by Duke Ellington, also arranged by Joe. And the guitar, as many of us already know, is a real chameleon of an instrument. It can go through to different genres. It's from be played and enjoyed by beginners and professionals and virtuosos. It can be played in bluegrass and samba, shoro music, classical music, folk music. And I think, you know, I was just talking with someone today at dinner about what makes classical guitar classical. It's a little bit hard to define, to be honest, because finger style or folk style they're all playing similar techniques and similar styles. There's a lot of overlap. So we're very fortunate that we can draw upon all of these musics so freely and integrate them into it. So I'm going to let the orchestra set up now. You can watch and it's like a spectator sport to make sure no one bumps their guitar on the stand. Because next to breaking a nail, that's probably the worst thing that could happen at this camp. I've really run out of things to say. Anyone, what else can I say to the internet? We can talk about Dave's beard some more.
Have a great time. It's been excellent.
The food has been excellent. We've been staying at a place called Endicott College, which is in Beverly, Massachusetts. You may not know where that is. It's close to Boston, but another close town that has a bit of notoriety is Salem, Massachusetts. That's down the road. It's a very picturesque campus with fountains and green rolling hills, and the ocean is just across the road. And as Pat mentioned, we've actually been treated to delicious food all week. We've got access to this wonderful theater, and we've been sleeping on beds hard as rocks all week as well. So we get the gift of finding out just how soft our beds are when we get home, and we'll be ever the more grateful for them. So I must be really running out of things to say, if that's what I'm talking about. So I'm going to let you watch the orchestra get set up. I'm going to grab my guitar and join in the back for Duke Ellington. Thank you again for joining us, and enjoy the orchestra.
Thank you.
direction. Okay, let's welcome to the podium Nicoletta for this.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you next year. Take care.